Shall we start? Okay. Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Aaron from Efficent. I am technical consultant from Efficent in Barcelona. I am going to present our application for purchase request. This application was developed kind of 5 years ago. I was actually not in Efficent at that time, and it is now quite mature. It started in version 7, and now it is already in 12. We didn't have time to migrate it to 13 yet, but it will be soon in 13 for sure. Okay. We are going to show how it is the application and the new features we added this year in version 12. Okay. So, first of all, I will show you where to try this application. So this application is in the Odoo community shop. You can go there to follow this link, search by purchase request, and you will see all the versions for the application. You can download and use it in your installation. It is completely open source. You can find all the code inside this repository, OCI repository. And there is a tool in the OCI where you can try directly in a live instance without downloading the code. If you go to the follow this link and you go to the module itself, there is a Rombot instance, which is actually an Odoo. You can try logging as admin, or you can log in as demo, and you can try this application. Okay. First of all, also we will explain what is the purpose of this application. The thing is, if employees want to buy something because they need something for their job, or there is something missing in the office, or whatever, there is a need for a common point. They need a document where to request whatever they need. And when they need, and if they need to specify what is the reason, they can also specify that. So normally the employees do their request, and there is some person in charge of reviewing every day what have been requested, and just approve, and then maybe this person or another person will from the purchase department will do the quotation, the purchase order. Also, we can also do purchase request for procure. Imagine where we sell a product and we need a component for that product, but we don't want to have stock, so we just make to order this product. So we can just set in the. We can create a purchase request for that every time we create a sale order for that product without, so there's a previous step. So that way we can benefit for all the benefits purchase request has. We collect all the purchase requests in a single document, so we can control by department what are the costs by department of the material or the services they need for their job. You can also benefit from the supplier. There is a better supplier selection, and we can join in a single purchase order and satisfy various purchase requests at the same time without doing everyday purchasing. And also you can trace not only the employee can trace what is going on with his request, and also the purchase department and also the guy at the warehouse knows what is this product that arrives for. Okay, so this is the notification schema. When the employee creates a purchase request, there is a purchase request manager that receives the notification. And as soon as the purchase request manager approves, the employee is notified. And if the purchase department confirms the purchase order, also the employee is notified. And when the reception of product is coming to the warehouse, also the employee is notified. There is some news in this new version regarding those notifications. We will come later to this slide. Okay. Basically, the approval process is what I just said. The purchase request user, which is the normal employee, just created a purchase request and request for the approval. And the purchase request manager can either approve or reject. And every transition between a state is notified to all the people involved. If the purchase request manager approves and the purchase department buy, then also both the purchase request manager and the employee is notified when we receive the products in stock. So we trace from the picking is coming to the warehouse where is going to go inside our company. So instead of showing to you some screenshots, I'm gonna do a small live demo so you can see how it is in Odoo. So this is the purchase request application. You can it has an own menu here, but yeah, you can also access from the purchase application. There is a link to the purchase request and the purchase request. In this case, I can just go to the menu for the application. Okay, so this is the administrator user. This is the purchase request manager, and this is also he also belongs to the purchase department. And there is some user here that requests some products. So he just clicks on create a new purchase request and fill the items he needs here. If he needs a specific date, he can also put it. It is defaulted to today. The product here is not mandatory because maybe sometimes the employee doesn't know what is the exact product here. So in this case, demo user is going to request some attendance machine, for example. Maybe there is attendance machines and the entrance of the office, but he wants something for his own private room, so that is cool. Okay, so this is all set, all good, so we just request. Okay, he's not able to approve. But time passed, and there is another employee that wants the same thing, so that's the same. So there are many requests every day, many products. But actually, this employee knows what is exactly what is a product. So he has sent the product. By the way, this is an actual product we sell in Efficient for the controlled attendance in Odoo. So this is RAS stands for RFID attendance systems. That's only that. Okay. So me as administrator just go every day and see whether the purchase request pending to be approved. I see there are two. Okay, we review. There's a an RFID attendance system that we need that. It's fine. So we just approve. We just approve all, and if we just update here, we are notified. This is already approved, so we receive an email. Okay. So I'm also I also belong to the purchase request to the purchase department. So I'm gonna actually create a purchase order. So I go to the menu, purchase request line, and there is plenty of filters we can adapt to our needs. But we want to filter in this case pending quantity purchase is not started. So we need to create a purchase order for this. So we just select all the lines and go to action, create RFQ. And we see the supplier is automatically set here. We can also, if we have some draft purchase order, we can select it from this side. And we can also type a different description here that is going to go to the purchase order. I'm, as a manager, I know what is this product, so I manually put it here and I create the purchase order. Okay, cool. Okay, I am purchasing two for the two requests. And just a moment. Okay, I'm creating the purchase order. It seems there's some issue here because the me as an employee should receive a notification here. I don't know if I set up it wrong, but we will continue from here. Okay, we are going to confirm the order and we are going to receive. But the supplier tells us he cannot ship everything at once. So he's going to ship one by one. Okay, so we just receive one and create the back order because the supplier is going to send it later, the other product. Okay, so we have received, this is done. And the employee knows he received a notification. There's a reception for his request. And actually, as I only receive one, the other employee did not receive any notification because the reception was assigned to the other request. Okay, and yes, so also in the reception, in the one that is done, we know exactly what is the request this is for. So we can adapt this to know what is the department of the employee, so we can the guy at the warehouse know exactly where he's going to put it. that product and know exactly where it's going to go. There is another module for that that is not installed in this instance, but is in the purchase workflow repository in OCE also. It's called purchase request department. Okay, so we received the other. So we validate the back order. Okay, so both are done. Okay, you see the employee that received the first item did not get any notification here. This is the previous notification, but only the employee that is going to actually receive the product is notified. So he gets the notification. So basically, yeah, this is the application. If we want to automate and create purchase requests for any procurement we do in our company, there's a setup we can do here as an administrator. I can go to purchase, for example, products. And there is a setting here on inventory called purchase request. We need to flag this Boolean field here and also the make to order field. And when we have that in the product, when we create a sale order, it will trigger the creation of a purchase request instead of a purchase order directly. So we can just try that. Customer, whatever, product. Okay, we are going to buy just one unit. Confirm the sale order. And this is waiting another operation. It's waiting to receive the item after creating the purchase order. So when we go to purchase request, we see the filter here to approve. Okay, it didn't create the purchase request, but it probably I misconfigured something in the route, but it works like that. It creates a purchase request, and then as soon as you confirm the purchase, as soon as you receive the purchase order, in the sale order, you will be able to unlock the sale order here. So it is this is the standard behavior, a previous step before the purchase order, because we want to benefit of everything, all the benefits of we have in this slide, like control the spending.
Conversion 11 or 12 or 2%?
And the difference here is, thank you for the question, by the way. The difference here is the filters here. We have on purchase request lines, depending quantity to receive. So we know exactly what is pending to be received. This is not available in version 11. And also in version 11, once we receive partial pickings, both requestor, both employees are notified. And now only the one that is going to receive the actual product is notified. So, yes. Here in the line,
we have the tracking, so we know what is pending to be received, what is actually in a purchase order, or in a not confirmed stock move, and what have been received. So basically, this is useful then here to know the next day what the purchase request manager or the purchase order manager does is going here to the lines and see what is pending to be purchasing not started. Okay, I create a quotation, and then he can also go here to the and put pending to be received to see what is the status of the purchase request. So this is what is new in the version 12. Okay, so I think I covered all the functionality here, so my speech ends here. So if you have any other question to ask, so feel free to ask.
In the receipt of the goods, can you also see from which purchase request the lines come from? For instance, you showed us a receipt with two lines for the same product, but only one was delivered. So can you, in the receipt, can you define for which purchase request did you receive the one item?
You have the information here, but in the notification, in the text, you only see the purchase request number. But as long as, yes, here. Sorry, not here. The purchase request and the what? The purchase request, I remove the filter. Oh, it seemed that the purchase was actually created when we triggered the sale, when we confirmed the sale order. It appears now. Okay, here, this is the purchase request. I have a link now to the purchase order. Also, this is new in version 12. And the reception. Yes, I see the purchase request number in the notification. And I see the product and the quantity. We don't see exactly the line because there is no line number in the purchase request. But the link from stock move to the purchase request is one to one. So potentially we can do that.
Can you have two lines in the
Sorry, can you repeat?
Can you have two lines in the purchase request, one line for one item and the second one for different items?
Yes, if we have a picking for two parts and we receive all in once, in the notification we have a list for all the items. So product A, product B, and the quantity received. So I don't know, I'm not sure if that was a question.
Can you create a purchase request? Can you open the purchase request in two lines and each line will need to connect to different POs?
The purchase request line, there is a link here. There is a link here to the purchase order lines, and from the purchase order line, there is a link to the purchase request line.
No, but can you open the purchase request with two lines and connect one to one purchase order and the second to different purchase order?
Yes, but you have to create them separately then. So you have to create two quotations in that case. Or maybe I don't understand your question. You mean you have two lines, two purchase request line, and you create just one quotation.
I wanted then to have two purchase order without quotation or past quotations.
from directly from the point cloud to the quest to point cloud to point cloud.
So without going to the lines, I'm not sure. So you have two lines and you create a quotation for the two lines. Mm-hmm. Is that correct?
No, without the quotation. I did already
pointed
to the
question. To be confirmed directly.
Yeah.
Actually that is not possible. Yeah. But that can be implemented. Also for the validation process. There is a very interesting talk regarding approval flows, which is purchase tier validation or tier validation, and we can specify as many validation types as we need in that case. Different stages and very customer stages. I think that can be integrated with this, and this is quite interesting for the future, maybe for versions 13 as well. Okay, so it seems I'm running out of time, so feel free to ask questions in the aisle outside, or yes, anytime you see me over here, I'm gonna be until Friday here, so feel free to ask. Okay, thank you.